Hello everyone, it's Axel from Segger. Today I want to talk about the slider object in AppWizard. So the slider object is a very useful object to select all kinds of things, like for example a temperature, or to fast forward in an audio clip, or to change the RGB values in this pie chart example here. So if you want to add your own slider to your GUI, all you need to do is select the slider object over here in the objects window, and it'll appear on your editor screen, and you can position it to wherever you need it to go. Now this is just the default example of the slider look and feel that you get in AppWizard. We are going to modify that later on. So the first thing I want to do is get an idea of the values that our slider is creating. So I will create some interactions. When the slider value changes, I want to set that value into a text box in decimal mode that I already have, and also into a gauge that I already have on my GUI. So now when we change the slider, we can see it currently produces values from 0 to 100, and those get displayed in our text box as well as our gauge. So let's look at the properties that we have for our slider object. You have the ID over here that you can change to whatever you need it to be. We have the position, the anchor point. Now here's an important one. If you want a vertical slider rather than a horizontal slider, you can easily do that, and our slider will be in vertical mode. You can also invert the direction. So currently the thumb is on the top, and that is our zero value. We can easily invert that by activating the invert direction setting. And now zero is on the bottom and our 100 value is on top. Of course, you can completely customize the look and feel of your slider with the bitmaps that you see here, like we can do with all the objects in AppWizard. So if we would like to give the slider a different look, you can choose from a different look in the preset images that come with AppWizard, or of course you can use your custom graphics as well. So let's choose this shaft bottom, and let's choose this shaft top. Give it a different thumb, and we need to make it a little bigger. You can also change the height here to whatever you need. And now we have a completely different looking slider for our GUI. You can even customize the look even more with adding some blend colors. So with this property here, you can add an additional blend color to the bottom of the slider, as well as to the top of it. And then AppWizard will blend the colors together when the slider is moved. So you can create all kinds of visual effects with that. The default range for the slider is 0 to 100, as we saw. If you want that to be different, if you want it to go from 50 to 150 or from 0 to 1000, that can easily be changed with the range setting here. If you would like to use the value of your slider in your user code, you could either use one of these existing interactions, because this is a slot routine that gets called when the slider value changes, and you could add your own user code to pick that value up in your user code. Either you can add it here in AppWizard, or you can code that in your favorite IDE. If we didn't have these interactions and you just want to pick up the value, you could do simply an interaction that says when the slider value changes, do null, and then in this slot you could add your user code to pick up the value. Of course, you can do a lot more things with your slider. So here's all the signals that the slider can emit. And then here's all the actions that you can take to react on that emitted signal from your slider. And to learn more about all these different jobs that you can do, you can refer to the AppWizard user guide. So in a nutshell, this is what you can do with a slider object in AppWizard. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please make sure to check out other videos on AppWizard. And thanks for watching.